श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरौ नित्यं मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ब्रह्माण विजहाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मोक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानमोह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिरूपारं सर्वेदान्तवीत्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्तोऽन्यद् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। I think we have to look at the tippana. Okay. Sat karyas rupe swarupe pravishati yadvina karyasya sthitir nasti tad upadana karanam uchyate. I think we saw this. No, we didn't see this. Okay. Karyotpatti sthitilaya karanatva. Karyotpatti sthitilaya karanatvam upadana karanasya lakshanam. This much we had seen. Because there are other vadas discussed here. So, karyotpatti sthiti laya, karana. So, karana for the karya, every karya has a karana, and that karana which leads to the utpatti sthiti as well as laya, all three, that karana is said to be upadana karana. That is the definition. Then, jagad utpatti vishaye, आरंभ परिमा परिणाम विवर्तवादानां मध्ये विवर्तवादः एव श्रेयान् इति विचारतः सिद्ध्यति। इफ वन इंक्वायर्स इनटू व्हाट काइंड ऑफ कारण उपादान कारण व्हाट काइंड ऑफ वाद शुड बी फॉलोड आरंभवाद विवर्तवाद सो इफ वन डज विचार देन विवर्तवाद एव श्रेयान् डेफिनेटली द बेटर ऑफ द टू इज Vivartavada. Not better of the two. In multiple vadas may be there. So, Arambha Parinama and Vivartavada. There can be another vada also. And in among these, we say that Vivartavada is better. Ajatavada can be even superior. Anyway, so here, when the spider was mentioned as the Karana, it was mentioned as the अभिन्न निमित्त उपादान कारण बट वॉट काइंड ऑफ कारण द तंतु विच कम्स फ्रॉम द शरीर ऑफ द लूता कीट दैट अंडरगोस परिणाम वेदर द स्पाइडर विच इज जीव रूप अंडरगोस परिणाम और नॉट दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन सो चैतन्य विद इन वेदर दैट चैतन्य साक्षी चैतन्य अंडरगोस चेंज और नॉट इफ इट डजंट देन इट इज विवर्त सो apparent change that which has no real change but appears to change is vivarta karana whereas that which changes is parinami karana in the case of the exemplified the brahma chaitanya shuddha chaitanya never undergoes any change but still is said to be karana because along with maya there is a change Maya undergoes the change, therefore Maya is Parinami Upadana Karana. Savayavaihi Anekaihi Karnadravyaihi Sanyoga Sachivaihi Ekam Avayavi Karyam Utpadyata Iti Arambhavadaha. What is Arambhavadaha? Arambhavada is just like what we see in Loka. There are so many parts which come together and make a Karya. So there are many karanas, so many parts coming together and creating something new which was not existent, This is the general thinking. That is Arambhavada. So, karyam utpadyate. Savayavaihi anekaihi karana dravyaihi. So, there are many dravyas which are karanas, which themselves are made up of parts. And the parts combine with parts of other savayava karana, and then mixed up is the end result, karya. Yatha anekaihi tantubihi sanyoga sachivaihi ekam patarupa karyam utpadyata iti. Ayam arambha vadaha. So example given is how the tantus, how the threads come together and make up a single cloth. Many threads come together to make a single cloth. Atramate karyakaranayoho atyanta bhedaha abhyupagamyate. So when you look at tantu and pata, in this Arambhavada, since there is an Arambha of a new Karya, therefore Karana and Karya have Bheda, Atyanta Bheda. Tantu is different, cloth is different. Jagadutpatti Vishe Arambhavadha Na Sambhavati. Now if you try to apply this to the exemplified, Prapancha is created afresh. Now this prapancha is completely different from its karana, which happens to be Ishvara here. That cannot be right. Jagadutpatti vishe arambhavada na sambhavati. It's not possible. Advitiya brahmanaha aparichinnatvena niravayavatvat na tatasavayavam jagadut pruthak jayeta. You cannot have a separate jagat. Jagadutpatti separate, which itself is made up of parts. So for Jagat Karya to come up, where parts are coming together, such an entity, even if you take it as a whole, entire Prapancha made up of parts, cannot have come from Advitiya Brahma, which is Aparichinna. Cannot be segmented, then where can you have Avayavas in Brahma to come together and become Savayava Jagat? So Niravayavatvat. Aparichinnatvena niravayavatvat. Because of Advitiya Brahma, which cannot have a second, cannot have parts also. So being partless, why? Because aparichinnatvena. Parts, you see that parts can be created, segmentation can be done. So you disassemble something and assemble it together. Like a toy, like a child's play, there are blocks. Child has made a truck out of it, then you can break it up and make a tower out of it. If that is your thinking, it is not possible because the karana is aparichinnatvena niravayavam. Cannot be segmented and therefore cannot have parts. Originally, if there are no parts, if you say that, no, I'll make parts and then assemble, that is also not possible because aparichinna brahma. Advitiya Brahma cannot have a second. If you say two Brahmas come together, that is also not possible. Therefore, Arambhavada is not appropriate here. How about Parinamavada? Parinamavadopi na prapanchotpatti vishe yujyate. Parinamavada also cannot be applied. Why so? Karanavastunaha prak siddha karanavastha parityaga purvaka avasthantara prapti parinamaha. What is parinamaha? If you say jagat is parinama, then what is parinama really? Avasthantara prapti parinamaha. Attaining a different state is parinama. That avasthantara prapti is purvaka, tyaga purvaka, parityaga purvaka. For an avastha antara to take place, anya avastha, avasthantara. So avasthantaram, anya avastha, avasthantaram. So that avasthantara prapti is possible only when anya avastha takes place. And what is that anya avastha? Anya avastha is giving up the earlier. So praksiddha karana avastha. There should be tyaga, parityaga of the earlier state. You cannot hold on to both states. So, like milk becoming curd, milk does not remain milk and become curd. You cannot use curd for tea and say that it is anyway milk. It isn't milk anymore. It has undergone change completely. So it has given up its status of being milk and avasthantara prapti, that is parinama, in the form of curd. So karana vastuna praksiddha karana avasthaya tasyaha parityaga purvaka avasthantara praptihi is parinamaha. Now Brahma, if Brahma has become prapancha and you say that it is parinama vada, then it cannot remain Brahma and become prapancha. So parinama vada is not right either. Yatha mrut parinamaha ghataha. Now this is an example which Shruti herself uses. But look at the Tippanakara. He says yatha mrut parinamaha ghataha. If you inquire into that, Shruti gives that example. But if you inquire into that, it is only to show that karya is karana bhinna, not to say that it is parinama. If you inquire into that example itself, you see the parinama. Because you cannot use the pot and mrut in the same way. Utility is different now. If you say mrut, the way mrut was, it is exactly in the same way it isn't. It has morphed itself into ghata. So ghata is definitely mrut, but mrut has morphed. It has changed form. So if you inquire into it, even Shruti just tells you that karya is nothing but mrut, meaning karana. Karya is nothing but karana. That is the only focus there. But if the focus isn't that, it is not undergoing change. Therefore, it is not an example for vivartavada. How much ever you try to convince yourself that ghata is nothing but mrut, if you inquire whether mrut has undergone change, yes, it has undergone change. You cannot refute the fact. Tarka-wise, it cannot be refuted. You cannot say that mrut without changing has become a pot. Without changing means mrut still remains mrut, but not in the same form. Therefore, parinama is there. So earlier avastha, it has given up. Praksiddha mrut, which is karana. Praksiddha karana avastha is what? Mrudavastha. That mrudavastha includes its rupa ityadi. So praksiddha karana avastha parityaga purvaka avastha antara prapti parinamaha is the case of mrut, which has taken parinama and become ghataha. If this is a difficult example to see, then the milk turning into curd can be used as easier to see. Because there are people who will argue that Chandogya Upanishad says this, how can you say that is parinama? Tatparya in that example is not having no parinama. The tatparya is that karya is karana abhinna. Because the question in Chandogya Shashtodhyaya, whereby the teaching began, is ekasya jnanena. Ekasya jnanena sarvam jnatam bhavati ekasya vijnanena. So that knowing the karana, karya is as well known, there the karya is karana abhinna. That much alone is the tatparya. Parinama is not the focus. Vada has not been established there. Yatha mrut parinamaha ghataha iti pradhana parinamaha jagad iti sankhyaha vadanti. And sankhyas use this example as well. They say that mrut has undergone parinama. You can't argue that it hasn't. It's a fact. And they say similarly, pradhana has undergone parinama. Pradhana is prakriti, maya. Iti cha sankhyaha vadanti. I'm sorry. However, Brahma parinama is not what they accept, which is all right. But they say Brahma is not needed at all. Brahma has nothing to do with pradhana undergoing change. Pradhana does it on its own. This much we do not agree with. If you say Brahma does not undergo change, we agree. Prakriti undergoes change, Pradhana undergoes change, we agree. But you say Pradhana is independent, we do not agree. So the Vedanta process is not to throw everything out, not to throw the baby with the bathwater. We accept whatever any darshana puts which is not Shruti Viruddha. As soon as there is Virodha, we replace that with Shruti. And that is how Vedanta comes about. It's not starting from scratch. We don't say, no, we don't agree with anything. Throw away this meditation of yogis, throw away the 24 tattvas of Sankhyas, Karmakanda, you throw away useless. We don't do that. We agree with each and every darshana as long as they do not have Virodha with Shruti. In any part of the explanation they give, whether it is useful or not, then we'll bring in what is useful and then build blocks. Yatha mrit parinama ghata iti pradhana parinama jagat iti cha sankhya vadanti brahma parinamo jagat diti kechana upasaka manyante. However, some upasaka say, no, all this prapancha is brahma parinama. Tad ubhayam sutra bhashyaka aradibhi khanditam. Whether it is pradhana parinama or brahma parinama, pradhana parinama, when you look into it, you have to say that it is independently pradhana. There is nothing backing. That we do not agree, because pradhana is, we have seen in just in the section gone by, we have seen maya is what? Ajnana, avidya. It is brahmashraya. Maya is brahmashraya. So pradhana, if you say it is separate, that is khandita. Brahma parinama, khandita. By sutrakara and bhashyakara. Chaitanyasya akashadapi sukshmatvena niravayatvad eva upasaka matam atyantam asangatam eva. Further, the upasaka mata, where they say that prapancha is brahma parinama, their chetana is one. So chaitanyasya akashadapi sukshmatvena, it is more subtler even than the akasha. Akasha is one, Chaitanya is one. Akasha is Sukshma, Chaitanya is Sukshma. But Chaitanya is subtler than Akasha. And Akasha is accepted by Nayayikas as Niravayava. So Niravayavatvad eva upasaka matam atyantam asangatam. Chaitanya, so same reasoning which was given earlier, that it is Niravayava. Cannot become a karana for anything. Itham parinama vadahapi na yujyate atra. So parinama vada is not applicable, does not stand scrutiny. So what is the real vada then? Vivarta vade tu purvokta dosha leshopi na sambhavati. Not even a whiff of dosha is possible in vivarta vada. The doshas which are mentioned earlier. How can niravayava, asanga, aparichinna become karana for prapancha? There, what is discussed as a real karana? Karana vastunaha nitya siddha swarupa parityagi neiva anyatha bhanam atra vivarta iti shruti yukta anubhava siddham. So shruti yukti anubhava siddham. Shruti yukti anubhava siddham is shruti yukti and anubhava. Shruti says that it is logical also, and it is there in our anubhava also. How so? Look, karana vastunaha nitya siddha swarupa aparityagena anya avastha. Anya avastha is anyatha. Anyatha bhana matram. Avastha is bhana matram. There is no real state which is separate. There is an apparent reality without giving up its earlier swarupa, which is nitya siddha. Always established so, never changes, but appears differently. That kind of karana, which appears differently but does not ever undergo change, well known to remain so all the time, that is vivarta, vivarta karana. Iti shruti yukti anubhava siddham. How is it shruti yukti anubhava siddham? Yatha shuktyadau rajatav bhasaha. This is the real example. Rajju sarpa. Shukti Rajata is the real tatparya of the Shruti, not Mrudghata. Mrudghata is mentioned, but from Mrudghata you have to go further to Shukti Rajata. Mrudghata may be easier to understand, but you inquire, this you see that change is taking place. Mrut changing into Ghata is not due to avidya. You cannot explain. If you say that Prapancha has come about just like Mrut has become Ghata. Therefore, avidya is a karana. Does not have vyapti at all. There is no vyapti. What you can know is karya is karana bhinna. The more you inquire, the more questions will come up, which is okay. But that is not the real tatpari of the Shruti. Shruti wants you to understand that karya is karana bhinna, but still, how without undergoing change it has become so. Swapna is the real example. Rajju sarpa, swapna. So, swapnavat mithya. Rajju sarpavat avidya karanam. Not mrudghatavat Mithya and Mrudghatavat Avidya Karanam. Complete Vyapti is not possible. Example is not complete. Does not fit. Thoroughly does not fit. It may remain unanswered for some at least. In fact, for many. Nonetheless, Shruti finally says Vivarta Karana. How can it be Vivarta? Difficult to see. Therefore, yatha shuktyadu rajatavabhasaha. Like the shell appearing silver. When the silver appeared, did the shell undergo change? No. Nitya siddhya swarupa was as shuktika. Did it do parityaga anyway? No. Aparityaga is there. So, aparityagena eva. Anyatha bhanam, is it there? Yes, appears as silver. So, anyatha bhanam matram. It is not anyatha bhanam matram, only an appearance. Nothing else. How so? Earlier we saw, devatayaha eshaha svabhavaha. This is the svabhav. Devasya eshaha svabhava. Devataya, if you take Srilinga, sadbrahma in Chandogya. Then all these three Mahabhutas are called as Devatas because they have come from Sat Brahma. They themselves are called as Devatas because even those three Mahabhutas have not really come up. Vivartavada, they are also Anyatha Bhanamatram. And this continues all the way till the last produce. And it keeps on coming up through and through, without ever changing. Ayam eva paksha vedanta abhimataha. This is the real Vedanta paksha. Everything is in passing, hand-holding. Baby steps till you get there. One cannot hold on to this. No, I don't want to go to Rajju Sarpa or say that Rajju Sarpa is wrong. Rajju Sarpa is the Vedanta mata, real mata. Atra jagat Vivartopadana Rupadishthana Maya Upahita Chaitanyam Eva. Then which is the real Karana? Is it Pradhana? No, you have said it is not Pradhana. What about Brahma? You have said Brahma also is not acceptable. Parinama is not accepted. What is accepted then? Atra Jagad Vivartopadana Rupa Adishthanam. What is the real Adishthana which is Vivartopadana Karana for Jagat? Maya Upahita Chaitanyam Eva. You cannot take Pradhana separately and or Brahma separately. Both are together. Without affecting Maya is Brahma Shrita. So Maya Upahita Chaitanyam Eva. Chaitanya is Brahma, Shuddha Brahma. And Maya is the Upadhi. Therefore, it does not affect Chaitanya at all. Is an Upadhi. Na Maya Vishishtam. Maya is not Visheshana for Chaitanya. Avivekinaha tatha kathayanti. However, avivekis say this. Now, this is also not real paksha. Parinami upadanam maya. Vivarto upadanam upahita chaitanyam. Iti viveke siddhi api. Tad ubhayam maya visishta chaitanyam. Iti vadanti vivechana kushalaha. although it is said that Ishvara is Maya Vishishta Chaitanya, that is not the real Vedanta Paksha. It is said because Upadhi is difficult to understand. Therefore, Maya Vishishta Chaitanya is Ishvara and then he is the Karana. This is Avivekinaha Kathayanti. Because Parinami Upadanam Maya, Vivarta Upadanam Upahita Chaitanyam, not Chaitanyam, Upahita Chaitanyam, there also. Iti Viveke Siddhyapi, even if through Viveka you can understand that Parinama is undergone by Maya and Vivarta Upadanam is Upahita Chaitanyam, not Shuddha Chaitanyam. Shuddha Chaitanya has no Karanatva whatsoever. Iti viveke siddhyapi tad ubhayam. When both are put together, maya vishishta chaitanyam iti vadanti vivechana akushalaha. Those who have no viveka, if they had viveka, viveke siddhye. But even if there is viveka, still they cannot hold on to this viveka and end up saying that it is maya vishishta chaitanya. It is not maya vishishta chaitanya because chaitanya was never having a visheshana, can never have a visheshana. It is an upadhi because visheshana will make it a qualifier. That kind of qualification we do not want to make because it is nirguna, cannot have any qualifying attribute. So that is the vivartavada, which is the tatpari of the shruti. Then yat karya surupe na pravishati kintu karyat prutak sthitam yat Sat karyam utpadeti yasya nashina karyam na nashyati tan nimittam karanam iti abhidhiyate. On that there is a tippana which says karyotpatti matra karanatto nimitta karanasya lakshanam. So karya utpatti matra karanatto, not utpatti sthiti and laya. Only for utpatti, something that is needed and has no play in sthiti and laya, that is nimitta karana. Tachya nimitta karanam aneka vidham. Now that nimitta karana itself can be of multiple types. What are those? Continuing on the next page. What do Nayayikas say? Nyayamate ghatena ishwarasya sanyoge ishwarasya abhinna nimittopadanatva muktam. Interestingly, Nayayika says Ishvara is karana. Jagat karana. What kind of karana? he says ghatena ishwarasya. Karanatvam. Ishvara is one karana, mind you. Ishvara is karana, all right. When you inquire into it, Ishvara is karana for everything. Kala is karana for everything. Without Akasha, Kala, all these are there, understood as being there. They are always there. So if you say, Ghata karana is Mrit, Upadana karana, then you say, Ghata karana is Kulala, Nimitta karana. What about others? I give you Mrut and Ghata, can you do it? No, I need Chakra and Danda also. So, Sahakari Karana. Danda and Chakra are needed. So, the setup is complete. Is it really complete? Can you keep it somewhere where there is no Akasha? Akasha has to be there, it is understood. Can you make it outside time? Please make it, but it should not come up in time. It is not possible. So, Kala is assumed. Similarly, Ishvara is Sarva Karananam Karanam. Sarva Karyanam Karanam, Karananam Vi Karanam. So Ishvara also has to be accepted. So they say Ishvara has Karanatvam for Ghata. Ghata means Ghata is an Udharana for everything in Prapancha. Anything created, Ishvara is also Karana. Nyayamate Ghatena Ishvarasya Sanyoge Ishvarasya Abhinna Nimitto Upadanatva Muktam. It's an Abhinna Nimitta and Upadana Karana Ishvara. He is Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana. Tatha Jivashrita Jnana Sukhadi Gunanam Jivasya Abhinna Nimitta Upadanatvam Abhimatam. So they take this argument because there is Sanyoga. Some association has to be brought in and then they say similarly Jivashrita Ajnana. Jivashrita Jnana Sukhadinam. So not Ajnana, Jnana. So jnana is in jiva. They say jivatma has jnana. We have seen this earlier. Jnana is an attribute in jiva. Sukha is an attribute. All these are attributes. So all these gunas, jnana, sukha, ityadi gunas are there in jiva. Jiva is the ashraya. Jivasya abhinna nimitta upadanatvam abhimatam. So they say jiva is abhinna nimitta upadana. Karana. Kincha yatha asmanmate jivasya sapna prapancham prati abhinna nimitta upadanatvam ishtam tatha eva isha tatha ishvarasya jagat prapancham prati abhinna nimitta upadanatvam bhavati. So anyway, Tippanakara is mentioning what their ideas are. We don't need all of that. For completion, we'll just have a quick look at it. Kincha yatha asmanmate jivasya swapna prapancham prati abhinna nimittopadanattvam ishtam. It is desirable. Whether they agree or not is a different story. But we say that swapnavat mithya. So swapna prapancha, who is the karana? Asmadmate. In our view, jiva is abhinna nimittopadana karana for swapna prapancha. This is our, you know, bread and butter example. For vivartavada also, for showing that prapancha is mithya, swapnavat mithya. There are not multiple karanas, there is only one karana. And there is no separate upadana from the nimitta karana, which is what Sadhu said yesterday. That main example, or Swamiji said that it is. Main example is Swapna, not spider also. Spider is an example given by Shruti. But it is also hand-holding till you get it right. Because there also you'll have questions. Spider and the web which is created, it stays separately. It does not maintain, may not maintain the web. Siddhi Karana, it isn't. And Laya Karana also, it isn't seen. I mean, it is also laya karana, of course, but then at least Shruti says that it is sthiti, srishti, sthiti and laya karana. Do we see that? Sometimes we see the web is just hanging out. I mean, we don't see that the web is absorbed by the spider. So Shruti has no tatparya there. It just wants to explain that it is possible. Only impossibility is removed. It is not the main karana, because still the sharira of the luta kita is separate from the chaitanya. There also we'll have questions. You are solving one problem by giving a solution which is similar to this setup where there are two different entities. We want to show there are not two entities, there is one entity. So we take spider as a whole, but if we inquire into it as per the teaching, then Chaitanya is separate from the Sharira. That is the teaching. Then how can you mix up Atma and Atma and show Abhinna Nimitta Upadana Karana? Example won't fit, because example can take you only thus far. Further, the Sadhaka is left to inquire into it. And when the Sadhaka inquires into it, then finally Mandukya will say Swapnavat Mithya. Everything will be collapsed into Pratibhasika itself. There is no Vyavaharika. So their Swapna example is the main example. This is what the Sadhu or Swamiji had also said. Further here, Swapna prapancham prati jivasya abhinna nimittopadanatvam ishtam, it is desirable. Tatha ishvarasya jagrat prapancham prati abhinna nimittopadanatvam bhavati. So this is how, but their example is Tantu. Their example is Tantu and Pata. Nonetheless, Nanu dukkha tatsadhana parihareva sukha tatsadhana sampadaneva ichha drishta ishvarasya tu dukkha tatsadhana yoho abhavat na tat nivritti ichha sambhavah. So dukkha and tatsadhana parihareva. So objection there as to dukkha and dukkha sadhana. As long as dukkha sadhana is there, dukkha may continue to be there. So you want to take away dukkha as well as dukkha sadhana. At least one of these you have to start somewhere. So you cannot take away both together. You resolve one. Sukha tat sadhana sampadane va ichha drishta. So there is desire towards taking away dukkha or its sadhana. Actually, and its sadhana. Sometimes sadhana cannot be removed. So, dukkha can be dealt with. Dukkha sadhana continues to be there, prarabdha vashat. एंड सुख एंड सुख साधना इज डिजायर्ड. ईश्वर से तो दुख तत्साधन यो अभावात न तत् निवृत्ति इच्छा संभव. ईश्वर कैन नॉट हैव दुख एंड नो साधना फॉर दुख एग्जिस्ट. सो देर निवृत्ति इच्छा इज ऑल्सो नॉट पॉसिबल देर. जस्ट लुकिंग एट इट वेर वेर वी इन दी मूल या जीव स्वरूप वर्णन. ओके देन पर्याप्त कामत्वाद ईश्वरस्य अपि नापि सुख तत्साधन संपादन इच्छा. एंड अनदर रीजनिंग गिवन इज पर्याप्त काम कृतकृत्य. दिस इज द रीजनिंग गिवन बाय द कारिकाकार आल्सो. ही सेज लीला ऑल दीज कथाज आर जस्ट कथास, दे आर नॉट द रियल तात्पर्य ऑफ द श्रुति. सो पुराण कथास ऑल राइट, बट देन पर्याप्त कामस्य कृतकृत्यस्य का लीला संभवति? नॉट पॉसिबल. अथ ईश्वरस्य इच्छा न कुत्रचिदपि युज्यते. बालानाम अकस्मादेव क्रीडायाम इच्छावद् ईश्वरस्यापि जगत् सृष्टि रूप विना सॉरी विनोदेच्छा जगत् सृष्टि रूप विनोदेच्छा निमित्तं विना एव भवति इत्यपि न. एंड इफ यू से देयर इज यू नो सडनली देयर कैन बी इच्छा बिकॉज़ चिल्ड्रन मे नॉट नीड एनीथिंग एट सम टाइम यू नो. But suddenly a child gets up and starts playing around. So, akasmad. Is it, you know, chaotic? Somehow, iccha comes up. Although, does not need anything, but suddenly, there is an iccha. That is also not possible. Yatha balanam chitte alhada rupa sukha prapti nimittaka iccha bhavati tatha purna kamasya ishwarasya alhada rupa sukha prapti iccha na sambhavati iti chenna. Now, Nanu has been, he is there. You know, how is this Srishti? How does this Srishti take place? What is the Ichha there? Because Ichha has to back before Srishti. And that cannot be like the Balas having Ichha. Balakas, Balanam Chitte Alhada Rupa Sukhaprapti Nimittake Ichha Bhavati Tatha. Is it similar? Or is it not so? So, Purvapakshe Purna Kamasya Ishwarasya Alhada Rupa Sukha Prapti Ichchana Sambhavati Iti Chetna Yatha Kalpa Vrukshadi Swashrita Purusha Sankalpa Rupa Nimittena Swasvabhava Deva Ashrita Purusham Purusha Manoratham Purayati. Like the Kalpa Vruksha. Kalpa Vruksha does not have a desire of its own but meets the desires of others. Similarly, if you say he is kritakritya, he has no iccha, but Shruti says there is iccha, iccha purvaka shrushti. That iccha is to meet the jiva iccha, jivanam iccha. Just like kalparuksha. Kalparuksha gives phala as desired by the blessed person. Similarly, Ishvara's iccha is not his iccha to make himself purna. He is ever purna. But still an iccha has to be inferred because if at all you consider Shrishti as being there, then Ichha has to be inferred. Just like Maya was inferred, Ichha has to be inferred. Without Ichha, there cannot be Shrishti. Now, this Ichha is not for Purnatvam. Just like Kalparuksha. Kalparuksha is ever Purna, otherwise it cannot give you anything that you ask for. It can because it is Purna by itself. पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते. सो तथा ईश्वरापि प्राणिनां फल फलदानोन्मुखः यदा भवति. हियर यथा कल्पवृक्षादि स्वाश्रित पुरुष संकल्प रूप निमित्तेन द संकल्प. हाउ इज द संकल्प ऑफ द जीवास ड्यूरिंग कर्तृत्व? व्हाट एवर इज द संकल्प दैट विल एक्सटेंड टू द फलवृत्ति व्हेन फल इज डिजायर्ड. फलाभिमुख स्वस्वभावादेव आश्रित पुरुष मनोरथम पूरयति. स्वस्वभाव देवस्य एषा स्वभाव appears differently, appears to give phala based on the karma of each and every jiva. This is the karma vyavastha. So if you inquire into how is desire possible to Ishvara, this desire is created due to jiva karma. जीव कर्म फला ड्यू बेस्ड ऑन द प्रारब्ध which is carved out of the Sanchita, which has come about due to each and every karma done by each and every jiva. Their own Sanchitas are the basis for Prarabdha being carved out, due for fructification. All of those put together creates an Ichha in the Maya Rupa Manas of Ishvara. Then there is Srishti. Otherwise, there cannot be Srishti because desire has to back. That desire is not his own desire, but it is a desire which comes up due to the sum total desires of Jivas, which is what we saw yesterday as Ishvara's dependency on Jiva Karma for Jiva Srishti, for Jagat Srishti. Thereby, Tatha Ishvara Api Praninam Phala Dhanon Mukha Yada Bhavati. We have seen earlier, if it is he is withdrawn, then there is pralaya. When he is intending to give the results, because the prarabdha is due for fructification, because kala is ticking, even in pralaya, kala keeps on ticking. Why does kala keep on ticking? Otherwise, you can't explain. How do you know that the prarabdha is ripe for fructification and this is the time for kalpa srishti? How does Ishvara know? Ishvara knows because kala is ticking. And we have seen yesterday, what is kala? Kala is Chaitanya Brahma Sambandha. Sorry, Chaitanya Brahma, Brahma Chaitanya and Maya Sambandha. So that Maya is ever there in the result, for it is because it is Ashrita in Brahma. Therefore, kala is also inferred to be ticking. Inferred to be ticking. That kala shows when the time is ripe for Srishti, and then Srishti begins. As per the Ichha of the Sankalpas of the Jivas, all the Pranis coming together and creating an Ichha in the Maya Rupa Manaha of Ishvara, and then thereby there is Srishti. Sorry. So tatha Ishvara api praninam phaladanunmukha yada bhavati tada jivadrishta rupa nimitteneva swasvabhavadeva jagat srishtyadi vishayaka jnanechha prayatnadikam karoti. So all this prayatna to create all that is due to swasvabhava, which is dependent upon jiva adrishta. Adrishta is the karma phala, which is karma linking the karma and the karma phala. Adrishta is that which links the karma and karma phala when the time is right, which remains in the jiva, that adrishta rupa nimitte neva. Ishwariya ichha jnana prayatna madhye ekaika api vyaktihi srishtyarambha kale utpanna pralaya paryantam tishtati. And this Ishwara ichha, Ishwariya ichha jnana prayatna madhye ekaika api vyaktihi. Each of these, Ichha, Jnana and Prayatna, continues to be there. So Ichha Shakti, Jnana Shakti, and then there is the all the three Shakti. Ichha Shakti, Jnana Shakti and Kriya Shakti. So that is Ichha, Jnana and Prayatna. Prayatna is Kriya Shakti. So all these continue to be there. Srishti Arambha Kale Utpanna Pralaya Paryantam Tishtati. Continuously remains during Srishti Siti and Laya. Tasmad Ishware Ichha Prayatna Nitya Uchyante. And therefore, this the Ishvara Ichha and Prayatna, all these are called as Nitya Kincha. These are all in the context. The Sadhu wants to, Sadhu has skipped through many details, but somehow Tippanakara feels these have to be filled in because there may be questions related to it. And why is Sadhu considering it? He has already said that Sagara Rupatvat Granthasya. So Grantha is, he wants to call this Grantha as Sagara. It is Sagara. So Sagara cannot be missing some things. Therefore, he is in the, in his stride, he is taking the Srishti Prakriya. There also more gaps are filled in by the Tippanakara. These are something which are not mentioned in many places which claim to be elaborate. In Prakarana Granthas also, you don't see so many details as it is in the Vichara Sagara. Kincha Ishwari Ichchadaya Bhuta Bhavishyat Vartamana Kalagata Sakala Padarthan Vishayi Karoti. So Kala is also mentioned there. Ishwari Ichchadaya, all these also Vishayi Karoti Padarthan. Which are these? भूत भविष्यत वर्तमान कालगत सकल पदार्थान ऑल दैट विच इज क्रिएटेड इन टाइम. अतएव सदा सृष्टि प्रलय वा सदा शैत्यम औष्ण्यम वा सदा वृष्टिर अवग्रह वा न संभवती. Because it's a continuous kriya, therefore something which has already happened in time does not continue to remain exactly so. It is ever changing. Therefore, we have seasons and all that is mentioned. Kintu samayanusarane eva bhavanti. So I went across pages. I thought that the same vada is continuing. It was end there, and it was a tippan on these. So the correction there will be two numbers here on which there is a tippana. I had skipped two pages of tippana yesterday. Therefore, I covered this as well. So, moving on, let's do a little bit of Moola. So, Jiva Swarupa Varnanam. Rajastamasi Abhibhuyodbhutaha Yaha Sattva Gunaha Sa Shuddha Sattva Gunaha Ityabhidiyate. So, what is Sattva? Shuddha Sattva Guna there? Rajastamasi Abhibhuyodbhutaha Yaha Sattva Gunaha Sa Shuddha Sattva Gunaha Ityabhidiyate. Rajastamobhya Abhibhutaya. There is a typo here. Should be Anabhibhuyodbhutaha. Should be Anabhibhuya, I think. So anyway, the meaning is this, that Sattva Guna, where we say, you know, the Maya is Shuddha Sattva Guna, whereas Avidya is Malina Sattva Guna. So there, Shuddha Sattva Guna is where So, Abhibhuyodbhuta, you can say it has not overpowered, so that it is, but Anabhibhuya, it should have been, I am not sure whether there is an errata, I haven't checked there. So, that which is untouched by, or we can need not say untouched, because all three gunas are there, that which does not overpower or that does not affect Sattva Guna, that kind of combination is called as Shuddha Sattva Guna. Whereas Sattva Guna, which is touched by and tainted by Rajas and Tamas, is Malina Sattva Guna. Iti Kirtyate. Idrisha Malina Sattva Guna Sahita Ajnanamsha Pratiphalita Chidabhasa Ajnanam. So Ajnana is this Malina Sattva Guna. And therefore, Idrisha Malina Sattva Guna Sahita Ajnana Amsha Pratiphalita Chidabhasa Ajnanam. And then Ajnanadishthana Kutastha Chaitanyam Chatrayam Militam Jiva iti Varnyate. We have seen the combination of three at the level of Ishwara also and Jiva also. This is a repetition, but showing that Malina Sattva Guna is Ajnana, and that Malina Sattva Guna, Idrisha Malina Sattva Guna Sahita Ajnana Amsha. Why Amsha? Because we have seen there is in Jiva, there is an Amsha. Ajnana Amsha. Ajnana is one, but there is an Amsha which can be seen in each and every jiva. Therefore, multiple ajnana aushas, but ajnana is one. And that ajnana ausha is also malina sattva guna sahita. And in that ajnana, there is pratiphalana of chidabhasa. Because chit is there. So, chaitanya, kutasya chaitanya or sakshi chaitanya, along with ajnana, which is malina sattva guna sahita, and then you have Pratiphalita Chidabhasa. So Chidabhasa, Ajnana and Kutastha Chaitanya, we have seen three put together is Jiva. But what is Ajnana there? Ajnana is Malina Sattva Pradhana. So Trayam Militam Jiva iti Varnyate. Soyam Jiva Karma Karoti Tatphalam Cha Ichchati. So who does karma? Jiva does karma. Kartutva Bhuktutva is Jiva. Jiva has it. And who is this Jiva? Jiva is a combination of Kutastha or Sakshi Chaitanya, along with Ajnana, and Ajnana, although being one, that Aumsha, Ajnana is Malina Sattva Pradhana, Malina Sattva Guna Pradhana, and the Aumsha manifests in Jiva, to make up Jiva rather. Jagat Srishti Varnanam, Ishwarasya Vaishamyan Nairgunyabhavaha. So Ishwara is not cruel, or he does not have partiality. That is being shown by Anadi. Anadi Srishti, so there is no way that Ishwara has become partial to someone and given some karma to karma phala to someone that one did not deserve. There is no cruelty and there is no partiality. So that is discussed in Brahma Sutra also. So Ishwarasya Vaishamya नैर्गुण्याभाव जीवस्य स्वकर्मानुसारेण उच्च उच्चावच भोगानुभवय भवाय ईश्वरः प्राणिनां पुण्यपापानुरूपां सृष्टिं करोति. सो ईश्वर सृष्टि मैनिफेस्ट दि वर्ल्ड इन कीपिंग विथ पुण्य एंड पाप ऑफ ऑल प्राणीज विदाउट एनी बायास. सो स्वकर्मानुसारेण जीवस्य स्वकर्मानुसारेण उच्चैण उच्चावच भोग अनुभव भवाय. सो द प्रारब्ध ड्यू इन व्हाट सेंस? इन द सेंस ऑफ सर्कमस्टांसेस विच आर क्रिएटेड सच दैट विषयाज आर क्रिएटेड सच दैट ईच एंड एवरी जीवा गेट्स द कर्म फल थ्रू उच्च भोग उच्चावच भोग थ्रू द उच्चैण अवच भोग. सो इट इज through the higher and lower bhoga meaning sukha and dukha. That's what it means. Uchchavacha bhoga is sukha dukha anubhava. So for sukha dukha anubhavata. So it's tadarthe chaturthi uchchavacha bhoga anubhavaya kesham jivanam really jivasya here eka jiva vada really jivasya swakarma anusarana uchchavacha bhoga anubhavaya ishvara praninam. But jatav ekvachan, we can say that ekvachan has been used, we can extend it jivanam. Jatav ekvachan, as a group jiva has been mentioned, but based on each and every jiva, we can take it that way. For each and every jiva, sukha and anubha, dukha anubha, which is due for fructification, Ishvara does this. So praninam has been given here. Praninam. पुण्य पापानुसार रूप अनुरूपां पुण्य पापानुरूपां सृष्टिं करोति तस्माद् ईश्वरस्य न वैषम्य नैर्गुण्यं विगुण्यस्तः. सो तस्माद् ईश्वरस्य बिकॉज व्हाट इज द सुख दुख भोग ऑफ द जीवा बेस्ड अपॉन इट इज बेस्ड ऑन हिज ओन कर्म दो ईश्वर हैज गिवन इट स्टिल इट इज बेस्ड ऑन हिज और हर ओन कर्म. देयरफॉर यू कैन नॉट से देयर इज एनी partiality or cruelty even where you see lot of dukkha. Tasmad ishvarasya na vaishamya nairgunyestaha nanu adya sargat purvam na karma asti prathama sargecha ishvara praninam uchchaneecha sharirani uchchavacha bhogansha srijati. So now there is a purva paksha which says what about the first creation? There was no karma then. Then on what basis did Bhagavan give sharira to anyone? And on what basis he gave sukha dukha bhoga? There is some partiality. You have to see cruelty there also. Those who didn't get equality, equal treatment. Prathama sarge. So prathama sarge cha ishvara praninam uccha neecha sharirani uccavacha bhogansha srijati. Tasmad ishvaraha vishama drishtihi eva akasmad vishama srishti karanad iti chenna. Somehow he created. Even if he did not have bias, still people have got different bodies and different sukha dukha bhoga. So how can you say there is no cruelty or no bias? It has to be inferred because in the first srishti it is like that. Therefore anadi is mentioned there. Samsara anadihi. So there is never a first srishti. There is always karma, jiva karma, because it is cyclical. Tasmad uttarottara srishti purva purva srishtau. तत्तत् प्राणीकृतं कर्म एव कारणं सृष्टेः इदं प्रथमत्व असंभवात् ईश्वरे दोष न दोषः. सो न ईश्वरे दोष ईश्वरे दोषः नास्ति. वाय? बिकॉज देर वॉज ऑलवेज एन अर्लियर सृष्टि विच हैड अर्लियर कर्म एंड देर फोर पूर्व पूर्व सृष्टि बिकम्स तत्तत् प्राणीकृत कर्म बिकम्स कारण फॉर पूर्व 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 सृष्टौ. तस्मा उत्तर उत्तर सृष्टे पूर्व पूर्व सृष्ट तत्त प्राणीकृतम कर्म एव कारणम. सो ई फॉर ईच एंड एवरी लेटर सृष्टि देर विल बी अर्लियर पुण्य ऑफ इन द अर्लियर सृष्टि. सो पुण्य इन द अर्लियर सृष्टि पुण्य एंड पाप अर्न्ड इन द अर्लियर सृष्टि बिकम्स द कारण फॉर ईच लेटर सृष्टि. देयरफॉर सृष्टे इदं प्रथमत्वा संभवात् दिस इज द फर्स्ट सृष्टि. सृष्टि कैनॉट बी मेंशन्ड कैनॉट बी talked about at all because it is always cyclical. Therefore asambhavat na ishvare doshah. So there are no flaws in ishvara. We look at 265 in the next hour. This is an easier section, so I'll try and go faster unless there is some convoluted tippana which may take some time. Sukha nityam suprakasham vyapakam namrupa adhishthanam buddhya bodhyam buddher drukyat nirvaparam sarva vedanta vidyam pratyak paramah tadeva annamatvam iti me nishchita matihi.